What's up, co-leaders? I first want to start by thanking you for volunteering. This Pine Retreat could not happen if you were not awesome enough to volunteer. So we're going to jump right down and make this video super short. So in the link in the description below, there's a link for the schedule for the whole entire weekend. You will be referencing this schedule a whole lot because it will have the responsibilities and locations that you need to be and the things that you need to be doing for pretty much every hour of the week or the weekend. Each of you will have a walkie-talkie that you need to have with you the whole entire weekend. This will help us communicate and for y'all to ask questions to me and make sure you're leading students in the right direction of wherever they need to be and whatever rules they need to be following. So let's quick go over the schedule. You can click the link below and then follow along if you want. So the students will get here at 5 p.m. There will be several adults spread out on the campus telling them where they need to go, what they need to be doing during that time. If you could be there before 5 p.m., that would be absolutely fantastic. I will be getting there at 2. So I will start setting up at 2. If you want to start setting up with me at 2, I could use all the help that I can get. So they'll get there at 5. We'll have dinner as they arrive. At 6, we'll go over some rules that they have to follow and that we have to follow. Then we're going to play a quick game of Underground Church. At 7, we're going to have worship. 8, we'll have a bonfire. And then at 9, we have to switch on and off showers because we have one bathroom. So the girls will shower at 9 p.m. and the boys will shower at 10 p.m. In the times when they're not showering, they can either play card games in the living room or they can have a Nerf war in the living room. That is up to them. But as long as they're inside, they have to be wearing their masks. They need to try their best to social distance, but at the minimum, they have to be wearing their masks. They need to be in their cabins trying to go to sleep at 11. And then there is a list of things on that schedule for us to do once those students are asleep. What's next? The next day, Saturday, we will have breakfast ready at 8 a.m. All of our meals will be in to-go boxes, so they're not having to come to a place, touch everything to get their food. We'll hand them a to-go box, and that is their food. They can eat that anywhere in the living room or on the back porch. They're not allowed to go anywhere on the campus to eat breakfast. That morning is split up by time, so the girls and guys can switch off in the bathroom. At 9 a.m. we'll have worship, and then from 10 to 1 we'll be at the pool. We'll be having a ton of games at the pool, and then some adults will be also preparing us lunch so we can have it at 1 o'clock as well. So when that is happening, when we have lunch, we're also going to have a small group time. And then at 2 p.m., we'll go down to the lake. We'll play Ultimate Frisbee. At 3 and 4, we're going to be doing, they have options. They can either kayak, play cornhole, and eat their snack. At 5 p.m., we're going to do a whole group sand castle building competition. And while that is happening, after that's happening, from 6 to 7, the showers will be open for each hour. It'll be separate. The same way it worked on Friday night. At 8 p.m., we'll do dinner in the cabin all together, hopefully with the doors open if the weather's nice to keep that air flowing. At 9 p.m., we'll do worship, and then 10 p.m., we're going to start midnight. 10 and 11 is midnight manhunt. During this time, we'll switch off and have different adults patrolling so others can shower, and then they need to be asleep at midnight. Sunday morning, adults will wake up at 7 a.m., start getting stuff together. Breakfast will start at 8 a.m. for the students, so that's when they need to be up and going. And then at 9, we'll do a cleanup, and then at 10 p.m., their parents are picking them up. So it's going to be a super fun weekend. There's a super short, not very detailed description of what we're doing, but that will give you an idea based off of, the schedule that I'm giving you. This schedule will be posted in the kitchen and some other places around the cabin that we can reference it. The students won't get this detailed of a schedule, but they'll get a similar one. So what I need from you, I need you to send me the time that you're going to be able to be at the cabin on Friday. This is so important for me to know so I can know how many adults I have at that time to place them in certain locations. Please try your very best to at least be there by 4:30. If students are getting there at 5, I want you guys to be comfortable and have all of your stuff set up by the time the students get there. So I cannot wait to see you Friday. Please text me at 678-637-4821 and let me know what time you'll be there. Bye.